Hello, DPS parents. Maria Robertson here with a tutorial to help you go into Skyward Family Access and make your learning environment choices for your DPS students.
We heard from many parents and staff stating help was needed to assist you guys in making selections in Skyward when filling out online forms. So I'm doing this video to walk you through the process step by step on how to log in to Family Skyward Access to make your selections for learning environment choices. You can access Skyward in many ways. There's a Skyward app on your student-issued iPad. You can use any mobile device such as your phone or any computer. Unfortunately, Skyward is not a responsive website, so you may need to scroll back and forth or left and right on your device to read the complete screen. The district does not have the capability to fix this issue. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to access the learning environment form on a computer. I'm going to use Google Chrome as my web browser. However, you can use Internet Explorer or Safari, but Google Chrome is the best compatible browser. To begin, let's start by typing in the web address, www.dps61.org/skyward. When you sign into Skyward, you'll need to use your credentials. If you don't know your credentials that were given to you, you will need to contact your school secretary to get assistance in getting your login credentials. Once you log in, it should look familiar to you. This is where you can go into Skyward and look at your students' grades and attendance. But for this purposes, we are going to pay attention to the left-hand side of the screen that's labeled online forms. When you tap or click on online forms, a pop-out box will appear. It will have a learning environment choice form for each student. Know that you do need to do this for every student in DPS. To begin, you want to click on fill out form. So you want to tap or click on that. Once you click on that, you will be at the home page of filling out the form. On the right hand side, you'll see that there are two steps in order to finish and complete this form. Right now, you're sitting on a welcome message from the district. This does say that the default choice for all families is virtual learning unless you go into this form right here and submit any changes. So to advance to the next step, you could do one or two ways. You can click or tap on step number one, learning environment choice, or simply tap or click on the button that says next. When you go to the next step, you're going to be asked if you want to complete the learning environment choice for the student, and of course you want to tap or choose yes. This is the actual form, and since I'm on a computer, I'm going to tap at the top where it says view full screen. This is a lot of information. I would suggest that you screenshot this message here on the form. It does have a lot of dates and deadlines that you may want to make note of. Particularly the mid-quarter starts of periods in which you get to choose if you want to keep your student in virtual learning or if you want to switch them over to in-person learning. Over to the right of those mid-quarter start dates are the deadlines that you must designate in Skyward in order for us to pull a report and begin planning for how many children we're going to have for in-person learning. Underneath the elementary deadline dates are for our high school. And then underneath here is where you start making your selection. So February 8th is the next selection period that you're able to make your selection for your learning choice for the student. February 8th, I'm going to keep my student in virtual learning and I want to not put them in virtual learning. So I'm going to indicate that with the drop-down boxes next to the statements, whether or not you want to continue with virtual learning or switch to in-person. Make sure that you put in your name and the date because that is your record of signing off that you filled out this form for your students. While you're in here, you can go ahead and make the selections for the next two selection periods. There is one for March 22nd. By that time, I feel pretty confident that the numbers for COVID cases in Macon County will have decreased. So I'm going to choose no with virtual learning, and then I'm going to choose yes to go to in-person learning. Once again, you will need to fill out your name and today's date for when you filled out this form. Something else that you do need to make sure you pay attention to is transportation. February 8th, my student, I chose to continue with virtual learning so I can keep this transportation question as a no. Transportation is a question that we need you to answer if you choose in-person learning. Transportation question is that, are you able to provide transportation for your student to school and back home from school? We are asking parents if it's possible and encouraging you to provide transportation on your own. This will help minimize the number of students that are on the school buses, which will in turn promote social distancing. If you are unable to provide your own transportation, please know that masks will be required to ride the bus and that your student will also receive an assigned seat when they ride the bus. So because on February 8th, I am doing virtual learning, I do not need to complete the transportation question. But on March 22nd here, I'm switching my student from virtual learning over to in-person. And so therefore, since I chose in-person, I do need to make a decision about transportation. For my case, I am able to provide my own transportation, so I am going to indicate that yes in this checkbox because I am able to do that for my student. For the April 26th date, I do feel comfortable with COVID cases. Hopefully will remain low for Macon County, so I'm going to choose no to virtual learning and yes to in-person. Once again, I'm going to fill out my name and today's date. And because I chose in-person learning, I need to answer the transportation question. So I'm going to do that and choose yes. Once you fill out the form, you must click on the button that says complete step one. So make sure you choose that, because if you do not complete step one and do not get this green check mark over off the side under where they list the two steps, that does mean you did not complete that step. So since I have my green check mark under step one, I need to go on to the next step, which is step two. You can navigate to step two one of two ways. You can tap or click on complete learning environment choice here at step two, or click or tap on the next step button. The next step button is strictly submitting your choices that you just did on the previous step. This will send the information over to the district so that we can pull reports for each building and start preparing for which students will be coming in person. So, but this is a very important step. Make sure you tap or you click on the button that says submit learning environment choice. Once you do that, you will get a confirmation message that says that it was successfully completed and submitted to the district for your student on such and such date. So what happens if you change your mind, which is perfectly okay as long as the Skyward form is still available? You would just go back into Skyward, log in under online forms again. This time, instead of fill out form, the option will say view. So you just click on view. Right now you're on step two, but know that step one is the area in which you made your choices for the designated mid-quarter dates. So I'm going to click on step one over here on the right. Over here it does show that you are in step one. So what I'm going to do is find the option on the screen. It says mark as not complete and make changes. So I'm going to click on that to mark it as not complete. It'll take you back to step two, but what you want to do is go back to step one. You can click or tap on Learning Environment Choice or choose Previous Step right here, whichever way you want to navigate to it. And now you'll see that this button down here is active. Before, it was grayed out, which is why you had to mark as incomplete and make changes. Now, if you are able to, now you are able to edit step one. The key is to continue clicking on edit step one until you see the message for the form again with all the different dates and deadlines. So I'm going to click edit step one on the screen. And then it brings you up to another screen again. I said continue to edit until you find the form. So I'm going to tap on this edit right here on the screen. Finally, there is the form again with all the mid-quarter start dates and the deadline. So then you know that you can make changes because here are the drop-down boxes. February 8th, I'm going to make changes here. Looks like the numbers for Macon County has gone down. I want my child to go into in-person, so I'm going to switch this over to continue with virtual learning. Change that as a no as of February 8th. I want my student to switch to in-person learning. Because I chose in-person learning, I do need to fall down to the next question about transportation and fill that out and let the district know that I will provide my own transportation. Therefore, we can pull reports, notify the bus company to make an assigned seat for the students that are unable to provide their own transportation. Everything else for the March 22nd date, yes, I want to continue with in-person learning. As well, again, for the April 26th date, I want to stay virtual, I want to stay in person for that date. So make sure that I have yes for all my transportation dates. Transportation yes here and transportation yes. So what I'm going to do is complete step one. You can find the complete step one at the very bottom of the screen right here. It may be on the top, but you must complete step one if you did make any changes. Again, you have to get a green check mark. If you look up here on the right, there's no green check mark. So completing step one and clicking on that will give you your green check mark. So there it is. I do now need to submit. If you remember, the second step is to submit the information on the choice form. And so if I tap on complete learning environment choice or click on the next step, it'll give me the option to finally submit my selection. And then once again, I get my successfully completed confirmation page stating that the information was given to the district for my student on this date. So hopefully that helps you navigate through Skyward how to do your selections for the learning environment choices. Thanks everyone, and have a great day.